I thought I'd make a video of what I'm doing at the moment. I'm making art. You don't really find stuff on the road all the time. This was, I believe, a garage sale. I don't know what kind of sign this was, but I shaped it into, it's going to be the frame for a girl stick figure. So that's her dress, and then I'll make her a head and some pigtails, and but for now I'm just wrapping her dress, and so I thought I'll make a video and chat while I'm doing it. So I don't know what I'm really gonna do. Like, I need to make money. That's what it boils down to. I need to find some way to do something that's going to actually make money, which wrapping stuff with duct tape is a lot of fun, and finding stuff on the road, but it's not like it's gonna make me any money. And my wheelchair, I'm about to have to pay the other $1,400 for the rest of the lift, and I need a van, and you know, plus it would be nice to go, I don't know, to the store and like get something without having to analyze and think about, like, okay, what am I screwing, am I screwing myself over by doing this? Am I putting myself in a bind for next time? You know, I don't know. So, like, I have a couple things that potentially could make money. I used to write. I haven't really been writing, in a really long time, and I feel bad because I have stories to tell, and I need to tell them, but, this is why I don't write my books, because I get distracted, like, all the time with silly little stuff, like wrapping wires with the tape. Oh yeah, this is, oh, that's another reason why. Oh, spasms hurt. And they kind of throw a kink in everything because, you know, when my legs spasm, then it tries to force my whole body into like a straight position, which feels really good in a lot of ways, but then it also hurts. And then depending on where my legs are when they start to spasm, it can hurt a lot because they've spasmed under the wheelchair or whatever and gotten like stuck or caught, and I can't do anything because, you know, half my body is like, I don't know, am I like pushing against the undercarriage of the wheelchair or something, or the bed or whatever, and you know, I just can't do anything. But that's why, I don't know, that's why it takes forever to get anything done. That's why real jobs, yeah, I mean, that's part of why real jobs would be difficult. Another reason why a real job would be difficult is because, you know, I have incontinence, and so that kind of puts a damper on employment opportunities. And then, there's also the fact that some nights I can't sleep at all, and then other nights, or I don't know, like on the nights I can't sleep, then you know, it kind of ruins the rest of the day because you can't really, I don't know, when you don't sleep it just makes everything sad. So anyway, those are the reasons why real jobs would be hard, but the things that I have that could make money. Oh, also my tornado jewelry. I have a brick and a board that we salvaged from a home that got destroyed in the May 20th, 2013 more tornadoes. And so I grind it up and destroy the stuff with my Dremel, and then I can embed it in resin, like jewelry. But I haven't made any of that stuff because I get so distracted with all this other stuff. And it's like, it feels like there are a million excuses. I mean, really, that's all I'm giving you. That's all I'm saying is just a million excuses for why I'm not doing the things that could actually, I don't know, but the tornado jewelry, even when I make it, then I'm not a salesperson, so I give it away. Like, last time I made a bunch of tornado jewelry, then I taped it up to, like, light poles around town and gave it to businesses and stuff. Because, you know, I'm not big into selling. And then I sat outside of Walmart one day with a big, you know, tray of them and gave them away still for donations. Like, you know, if people wanted to donate, then that would be great. But you could have a free necklace. But, you know, I don't know. I guess the biggest thing is, like, how do I focus? How do I make myself, I don't know, should I even, everything that I believe in, all these quotes, all these signs, they say follow your heart, live passionately. It's not about the money. It's, you know, and what's that song? It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. Anyway, so I shouldn't care about money, and I really don't. But, you know, it is a reality that I need a van. I need a wheelchair that runs. I need the lift on the wheelchair so I can actually do stuff. And I need to be able to, I don't know, once I get a van, then I'm going to need to have gas and all this stuff. So anyway, I need to focus on something that might make me money. I think the best, like, the most potential is my writing. Because I'm pretty sure I could get something published, but I just need to sit down and focus and finish something. The most recently, I'm trying to write some children's books about a kid in a wheelchair. I kind of had the first one already, like, down, but then, I don't know, I've had some ideas recently that I think I want to take the story in a different direction, and so, you know, I need to rewrite it with this new, place where it's going that I have in my head, but all of that requires commitment, dedication, sucking it up, realizing I have potential, I have passion, I have the ability to do a lot of different things, and I can still make art, I can still wrap wires with duct tape and stuff, but, you know, I think that life is getting to the point where, like, amongst this stuff, if, I don't know, I'm gonna get into the Patreon stuff more and try, see if maybe I could really work with that and explain why I really need people to help me out and to support me, but, I don't know, I feel like I'm doing valuable stuff. I feel like all of the dancing, all of the, you know, just quotes on my chair and making people smile and being silly, and then all this art stuff, which is specifically designed to just, when people notice it, then it'll be like, you know, double take, wait a second, what? Does that bridge really say why not? Yeah, does that, is that a hubcap? You know, on the road, wait a second, is that a yard sale sign, you know, bent to look like a girl stick figure? These are all designed to just make people stop and snap out of the, like, mentality that, like, oh, everything in the world is all wrapped up in a pretty little package called an iPhone. You know, that's not reality. And hopefully these things, and if nothing else, then yeah, a girl dancing around in her wheelchair, and I'm also actually learning some real moves. I found a video dance tutorial of the song that I really love to dance to. I love the rhythm and stuff, but this guy has like an actual dance, and it would look awesome if I can actually learn it, but and of course I can't do all the leg stuff, but I plan on learning the upper body moves, and then I'll tag him and stuff in the video, and then we'll, you know, I'll learn like real moves. I would have like one actual song that I could do a dance to. It would be so cool. But anyway, this video is getting long. I should stop it. But thanks for listening. Thanks for hanging out while I wrap a girl. Does she look like she, can you see the dress? I don't know if I should take the duct tape and like twist it together and run some strips back and forth to make her dress like striped. I think I might do that. But anyway, I'll end this video for now. Bye YouTube. Thanks for being my sounding board.